Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some faith are meant to be so.
Looked brown to me. The world had less color without you.
Shapes in the sky looked plain to my eye. The world had less color without you. I know plenty of people with eyes closed. They don't see you like I do.
Notes on the keys meant nothing to me. The world didn't sing without you.
Birds in the trees, those singing for me. The world didn't sing without you. Without you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome and a greeting of peace. Please be seated. Please let us remember that a wedding ceremony is only a sacred form. To be true, though, it must be a symbol of something inner and real. A sacred personal union which nature might marry, church might solemnize, or a state declare legal, but which only love can create and mutual loyalty fulfill. With this thought in mind and heart, please, let us pray. Lord, please behold our family here assembled. We thank you for this place in which we dwell, for the love that unites us and for the peace accorded us this day, for the hope with which we expect tomorrow, for the health, the work, the food, and certainly the bright skies that make our lives delightful, and for our friends on all parts of the earth. Everyone, please, amen.
Amen.
And now may I have our readers please come forward.
I Will Be Here by Stephen Curtis Chapman. In the morning, when you awake, if the sun does not appear, I will be here. If in the dark we lose sight of our love, hold my hand and have no fear. I will be here. I will be here when you feel like being quiet. When you need to speak your mind, I will listen. Through the winning, the losing, the trying, we'll be together. And I will be here. If in the morning when you awake, if the future is unclear, I will be here. As sure as the seasons were made for change, our lifetimes were made for years, and I will be here. I will be here, and you can cry on my shoulder. When the mirror tells us we are getting older, I will hold you and watch you grow in beauty. And tell you all the things you are to me, we'll be together, and I will be here. I will be true to the promises I've made to you and to the ones who gave you to me. I will be here.
We are gathered together in the presence of these witnesses to join Lindsey and Jordan in matrimony. Marriage is an honorable estate, and therefore is not to be entered into lightly or unadvisedly, but discreetly, soberly, and with true love. Please remember that love and loyalty are the foundation upon which a happy home is built. If the solemn vows which you are about to accept are kept, and if you steadfastly to endeavor to lead honorable and worthwhile lives, the home that you establish will abide in peace, and your marriage will be lasting. Please remember that a good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, it's the little things that are the big things. It is never too old to be holding hands. And as remembering to say I love you at least once each day, please practice. It is never going to sleep angry. It is having a mutual sense of common values and objectives. It's standing together face of the entire world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It's speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and to forget. It's giving each other the atmosphere in which the other can grow. It is finding room for things of the spirit. It's a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. No other human ties are more tender, nor vows more sacred than those which are about to assume in a moment or two. And before we do this, though, I have a request. Now, in this moment, I have the opportunity of seeing several, many happy, smiling faces, which is letting me know that you're going to be receiving many words of congratulation and good fortune for the rest of the evening, for the rest of your married life. Everything that is occurring in this moment, the nip in the air, the heart, your heart's beating, the sound of my voice, all of these things that are happening, everything can be put into one word because it is the meaning behind this one word that all of us have come literally from near and far to me with both of you right now in this moment. So it is from the bottom of my own heart that I ask you to remember only one word. You heard this one word echoed in the scripture, in the reading we had. This one word, of course, is lovers. You love each other. This is the only reason why we're here, right? So do I have your promise that you remember at least that one word of all the words being said, lovers? Thank you. Now, when you both came into this spot, you left a particular dimension, the dimension of single life. Now, I don't know if the two of you are up on Stargate or Stargate Atlantis, but when you enter into the portal, you're between two different dimensions. You are now in the portal. Because when you walk out, when you go down the aisle, you enter into yet another dimension. The portal opens up and there you are. Now this portal of married life, which is altogether different than single life, to which you never again can return, this portal of married life has the opportunity of providing different circumstances, situations, and events. Some of which some people might label as issues. Now, I have an issue with issues. Oops. There's another one. Oh, my gosh. Where are these issues? This is real. Feel each other's hands? That's real. But these issues are not. Anything that exists in the head is a fantasy. Issues are a fantasy. Now, we can blame the Holy Spirit for putting them there, but we put them there. So if we put them there, guess what we can do with them? Let them go. That is, of course, unless you want a little bit of drama in your life. Now, the more drama you want in your life, the more you'll hold on to these issues. Otherwise, just remember, 1,000 years from now, it won't matter. If it doesn't matter 1,000 years from now, it doesn't matter now. Yeah. So, I can go on, but do you want to get married in the meantime? So, take a couple of deep breaths, please. And let all the stresses and the strains of the day disappear. And in another breath, allow all of us that are here present to join with you both in your hearts so that we may be supported with you as you make your vows.
Lindsey, when we first met, I didn't think I could have ever dreamt how happy you would make me, how much love you would give to me, how much I would love you. And I love you because you are, among many, many things, the most amazing woman who loves unconditionally, is compassionate beyond all measure, and is patient. Especially with my slight obsession with fantasy football. And because I love you, I promise to care for you in the same way. The love you get will always be equal to or greater than the love you give. You give me cookie, I give you cookie. No matter what comes our way, be it times of health or sickness, rags or riches, failure or success, I vow to cherish, respect, and protect you for as long as we both shall live. You know, the memories we've already made are priceless. Surviving New York, living it up in Paris. And our future holds no bounds. Every day is a new adventure. It's one I embrace and look forward to with you by my side. I love you, my wife. And that's the beginning and end of everything.
You are my best friend, and I feel so lucky that I'm able to wake up to you every morning and come home to you every night. You spoil me with your amazing cooking and the way that you keep me in good music and great wine. It also doesn't hurt that you happen to be really, really ridiculously good looking. I love that we have so much fun together, that you tolerate and sometimes join in on my passion for singing obnoxiously loud on off-key in the car. And that the fact that over the years you have developed a well-versed dance vocabulary. It means the world to me that when I have big, audacious dreams for our future, you see them too and are just as excited about them. Experience has taught me that if things get rough for us, you will be unwavering. In our darkest of times, you were strong when I couldn't be and gave me strength when I had none. In your arms, I always feel safely secure. I love you more than I thought someone could ever love another person, and that love grows with every beat of my heart. I am so lucky I found you to walk next to me on this journey. Your intelligence and adventurous, generous spirit inspires me to be better in all aspects of my life. I cannot wait to travel the world with you, to raise a family with you, and to create a lifetime of memories with you. You are going to be an amazing father one day. Thank you for making me laugh every day and for the strength that we share and will continue to share always and forever.
You declared your consent before this community here of your family and friends. May your faith in each other and the support of your family and friends strengthen your consent and fill you both with happiness. What has been joined together, let no human being divide. Everyone, please, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. May we have the ring, please. May these rings be blessed, and may these rings remind this bride and groom that they are to live together in joy, peace, and harmony. With this ring. As a token of my faith.
As a token of my faith.
And a symbol of my love.
And a symbol of my love.
I take you now as my wife.
I take you now as my wife.
Amen.
Amen.
And now please say Jordan.
Jordan.
With this ring.
With this ring.
As a token of my faith.
As a token of my faith.
And a symbol of my love.
And a symbol of my love.
I take you now as my husband.
I take you now as my husband.
Amen.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I invite us all to please stand as together we impart the solemn blessings by raising our right hands. The ring is just a symbol of your marriage. Symbolic of the fact that you have this day pledged yourselves to each other in marriage. And as the ring is a perfect circle without end, it is the wish and the hope of all here present that your marriage will be perfect and will be without end. Everyone, please, a confirming amen.
Amen.
Thank you. And for as much as Lindsey and Jordan have consented together in wedlock and have witnessed the same before each of these witnesses, and there too a pleasure troth each to the other, and declared the same by the joining of hands, by the authority vested on all of us here present, we now pronounce you husband and wife. Please kiss your bride. Amen.
Woo-hoo!